My name is Dr. Barbara Cade-Menun, and I'm a nutrient cycling scientist based in Swift Current, Saskatchewan. Well, nutrient cycling is when nutrients are taken up by plants and then eventually returned back to the soil where they're broken down again during the process of decomposition. Phosphorus is an essential element. It's required for all organisms for life, and it's part of our DNA. It's part of what gives us energy. In Saskatchewan, our soils are naturally high in phosphorus because they've developed on the prairies a lot of nutrient enrichment going back in from the grasses that were there. But as we start growing successive crops, we draw down our supplies of readily available phosphorus. We have a lot of phosphorus there, it's just not in a form that the plant can take up. Phosphorus fertilizer is a limited resource because it's mined from rocks, and so we're going to run out of it at some point. What we need to do is start recapturing some of what is lost in waste from manure and human sewage sludge. Okay, we may not necessarily want to apply sludge directly, but why can't we recapture that phosphorus chemically and find some way to convert that back into the fertilizer pellets that we know? We can be much more strategic about what we apply, but also explore other forms of phosphorus that are there, and getting plants to use the native forms that are in the phosphorus rather than having to import something or microbes that may help the plants use it more.
The development of nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy technology has allowed Agriculture and Agri-Food Canada scientists to understand phosphorus cycling at a molecular level. By studying the cycle, researchers get a complete picture of how phosphorus moves, and thus get a better understanding of how to manage phosphorus more effectively. The goal is to make phosphorus fertilizer usage more efficient and environmentally friendly by reducing the amount of phosphorus lost each year from agricultural lands due to water runoff. This soil research is made possible by a partnership between AAFC and the Saskatchewan Structural Sciences Centre at the University of Saskatchewan. With a probe purchased by the department, Dr. Cade-Menun uses the nuclear magnetic resonance machines at the university to test her soil and runoff samples.
We can take a sample and put it in a tube, so we're concentrating a lot of phosphorus. We put it in the tube in that machine, and that allows us to generate a spectrum which identifies the specific forms of phosphorus that are in there. The understanding ways to try to use exactly what we need in the form that we need it will help to make our fertilizer use more efficient.
Knowing how to use phosphorus fertilizers more efficiently and understanding how a plant uses existing soil phosphorus will help us to minimize phosphorus loss from agricultural lands, thereby minimizing the impacts of agriculture on the environment, all while saving farmers money. To learn more, check out our other videos on soil science in Canada